I think people discriminate because they have a fear of something they don't understand and that they don't know. So it's that fear of unknown and fear of unfamiliar, which causes them to become defensive and discriminatory.
Discrimination largely comes from lack of education. And it comes from our easy access to porting negative feelings to the world.
Ultimately, I think they're just uncomfortable with how other people live their lives. If it's not how they live their life and that's what they're comfortable with, if someone does something different, that's uncomfortable for them or that's weird, and I think they judge that.
I think it's a lot to do with not knowing.
Knowledge, knowing with familiarity gained through experience.
I had someone say fag in my ear, referencing something else when I was on air, talking about something else that was, they were talking about someone else that we were showing on in a news piece. And it's those moments you're like, you feel it. And then, you know, it's not about me. It's, I'm sure they're a lovely person. They didn't mean it. So you start justifying why it was okay that person said it.
It's, you know, almost like a cry for help that someone's lashing out and saying these things that they might not mean, but they don't know how else to express that they also need help or that they don't understand.
Human nature has some sort of sadder, darker elements to it, and a way of group mentality and choosing that something's better or greater than something else, and sort of picking on someone.
People always think that I'm the exception, but I'm not an exception. I am who I am.
Exception, an oral or written objection.
If someone hated people in the LGBT community, they better not say anything about it. And now some people say, well, that's censorship. And I'm like, not really. Like, if you hated your colleagues because of who they love, then that's on you.
It's the level of not willing to be educated to their ignorance that causes them to be discriminatory without them knowing.
The more people understand and the more educated people are, the less they are going to hate things.
You don't have to agree with everything, but when you're discriminating, you're not getting your point across logically.
We can agree to disagree. You don't have to like me. But what I would rather is that you're not out prosecuting some sort of idea that I'm a bad person because I happen to be born gay.
Prosecute, to bring action against, to punish.
I think this world could use a little more empathy. Like, I don't think we're gonna be like, oh, there's too much empathy. People might say, oh, there's too much political correctness. Fine, I think that's an argument. That's a valid argument. We should have that argument. Let's talk about it. Empathy, I think we could use a lot more empathy. No matter your political stripe, no matter your sexuality.
Empathy, to vicariously experience and understand the feelings, thoughts, and experience of another.
We're still a very long way away from where we need to be. We still have way too much work to be done.
There's nothing that makes a gay person 10 times different than a straight person. At the end of the day, we all have the same makeup inside.